Good evening, students. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
See, yesterday we were discussing some important concept, right? That is uniform circular motion. And we were in the process of deriving an acceleration. What acceleration was it? It is the centripetal acceleration. Acceleration, right? So what do we mean by centripetal acceleration? Before we start with the derivation, let's recollect certain basics, okay? In the first 2 minutes, let's just recollect the basics. So what are all the points I told you yesterday? So when the particle is revolving from one point to another, the angle swept is taken as theta, and this is taken as omega. This is r and this is r. And if I take this length to be s, then s will be equal to r theta and v will be equal to r omega, and a is equal to r alpha. I hope you remember these things, right? So what does this acceleration stand for? It stands for tangential acceleration, right? That's why we write it as AT. And remember this expression. This expression is mostly used in the 7th chapter. Okay, this is the mostly used expression in 7th chapter, which we call it as tangential acceleration. Okay. So apart from tangential acceleration, an object in a circular motion will also have an acceleration towards the center. Then that's what we call it as. What is the name of it? We call it as
centripetal acceleration.
Centripetal or radial acceleration. Right. Now the question is, what is the value of centripetal or radial acceleration on the basis of all these parameters? That's what we are going to see. Okay. For which we considered a part of a circle like this. Right, in that circle, what did we do? With respect to the center, we took the initial position over here. I hope you guys remember what is position vector, right? So position vector is a vector whose initial point is origin, but here, okay, I'm calling it as a radial vector. So initially the position of the particle was at P, and finally, let's say it is at Q, where this I will call it as r vector, and this I will call it as r dash vector. And here the velocity will be perpendicular v vector, and here also the velocity will be perpendicular. It is v dash vector. Okay, and what is going to be the angle that is getting swept here? Is it not delta theta? Right. Now, listen, guys. If I take a separate diagram of OP, okay, then this is R vector. If I take the separate diagram of OQ, then this is R dash vector. And if you join from P to Q, then how much will this distance be? It is going to be r dash vector minus r vector, which we called it as delta r vector. I hope you remember this. So which we call it as equation number one. Any doubt till this step?
Understood, sir.
Yeah? No. Observe, if I take this v vector and place it here, and if I take this v dash vector and place it here, then I can join those two to form a triangle, which is something similar to this. Are you guys able to understand what I'm trying to say? I repeat it. Observe. So what I'm trying to say is, I'm just taking this part and extending parallel and keeping it here. so that it becomes an equal vector. You guys remember what is an equal vector? So equal vector is a one which has the same magnitude and direction. Similarly, if I take v dash vector and project it exactly parallel so that the tails are meeting, then I can complete another triangle where this I will call. So guys, try to understand. Then if I call this as v vector and v dash vector, what will this side be?
V dash minus v vector.
Yes, v dash vector minus v vector, which we can call it as delta v. Accepted? Right. So if you observe, there are two triangles that are getting formed. Means if this angle is taken as delta theta, then how much will this angle be?
Sir, okay. It is the same.
It is the same because if angle between two lines is theta, then the angle between their corresponding perpendiculars is also theta. Perpendicular is also theta. Clear, guys? So this is an important point to be noted. So R vector and V vector are perpendicular. R dash vector and V dash vector are perpendicular because for a circle, V dash and V are the tangents, right? Since they are perpendicular, then the angle between R dash and R is theta, means that is delta theta. Then here also it is going to be delta theta. Okay. Am I clear, guys? Now comes an important question. Right. So
it's
what
is repeat, sir?
Sorry?
Could you repeat?
Repeat which point?
Sir, how that angle is theta?
Because they are perpendicular, no? You take an example and see, no? Okay, let's say this is the triangle. This is purely geometry, huh? Okay, this is perpendicular. Now, I extend this perpendicular, I extend this perpendicular. Then what is going to be the angle between them? That is what we need to find. Right? So if I take this angle as theta and this whole angle is 90, then how much will this angle be? Wait. So this is 90 and this is 90. It is purely geometry, guys. This is 90. Then how much is this angle going to be?
Wait.
This is the line and this is the one which is perpendicular. Wait. So this is the perpendicular line. So this is considered to be 90. Then this angle is also 90. Yes. So it forms a quadrilateral. If I take this as x or alpha, for example, then theta plus 90 plus 90 plus alpha is how much? It is going to be 360. So how much is it? Alpha will be 180 minus theta. Accepted?
Yes, sir.
So this is 180 minus theta, means how much will this be?
Theta.
That's what I wrote.
Okay, sir. Understood, sir.
Okay. So alpha is equal to 180 minus. So that is the meaning of the statement is. Okay. Now I want to read out something important from the textbook, and I want you all to underline this. So if r and r dash are the position vectors and v and v dash are the velocities of the object when it is at point p and p dash as shown in the figure, by definition velocity at any point is along the tangent at that point in the direction of the motion. So this word is to be underlined. Okay, this first thing to be kept in your mind. And the velocity vectors v and v dash are shown in the figures. So delta v is obtained using the triangle of vectors of addition. Now see, since the motion of this particle is circular, we know that velocity vector and r vector, v vector and r vector, similarly, v dash vector and r dash vector are perpendicular to each other. If that is the case, can we conclude that delta v and delta r are also perpendicular? Look at this diagram. If these are perpendicular, if these two are perpendicular, then what we are going to conclude is that these two, delta V and delta R, are also perpendicular. If that is the case, when they are perpendicular, if you observe in terms of line segment, P, P dash actually forms the chord of this triangle, accepted? So if this is 90, this is also going to be 90, right? So if this is 90, then what will happen is, with respect to the chord, if you draw a perpendicular, that will always pass through the center. So what is the important conclusion that we can draw from here is that the change in velocity that is there is always directed towards the center of the circular motion. Okay, so delta V, when it is perpendicular to R bar, then we can say delta V by delta T is also perpendicular to R bar. And this delta V by delta T is what we call it as the centripetal acceleration. Or actually we can call it as average acceleration as of now. I'll tell you, this average acceleration is what is the centripetal acceleration. As of now, let's call it as average acceleration. So why we are calling it as average? Because you're using delta. Had you used dv by dt, it would have been instantaneous acceleration. Is this point clear, guys? Are you guys convinced with this? So the average acceleration is also perpendicular to r bar. Guys, am I clear?
Yes.
So delta V and delta R are perpendicular. Hence, A vector, A bar, it is not A vector. A bar is equal to delta V by delta T is directed towards the center of the circle. Okay. Now observe, if delta T tends to zero, delta T tends to zero means this kind of a value is called as infinitesimally small value. I have introduced this limit in the case of differentiation. Infinitesimally small value. Then what will happen is A bar is equal to limit delta T tends to zero, delta V by delta T will always be directed towards the center. Okay, am I clear, guys?
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, how is the delta V vector is coming directed towards the center, sir?
Because V and R are perpendicular, and V dash and R are perpendicular. Since delta V and delta R are also derived from the same triangle, they also should be perpendicular. See, that is what
the center and V are perpendicular.
Yes. So V and R are perpendicular. V dash and R dash are perpendicular. And obviously, delta r is a part of this triangle CP dash P, CPP dash, and delta v is a part of the triangle GHI. When these two are perpendicular and these two are perpendicular, then delta v and delta r also will be perpendicular only.
Yes, sir, but delta v can still be perpendicular to delta r without passing through the center also, right?
How will it not pass? From the center, tell me a line that you can draw on a chord which is perpendicular. So without center, you're
so not to from the center, sir, like the outside, like the velocity, the delta v vector is drawn like straight through the perpendicular okay. to the delta r without passing through okay. the center.
Okay. But here it is mentioned, no, see, delta v is perpendicular, see. You mean to say it will be somewhere from here also?
Yes, sir.
No, that cannot be possible, no? Because these are all extensions of it, right? Exactly, they are revolving in that way. That is why I should have actually shown an animation.
So then how is V and delta V extended at that point only, sir?
It is not extended at that point. Actually, what I did, I took it to that point, that's it. So you are getting the doubt because I drew the diagram like this. You're thinking this is the answer. No, that is not what happens. According yes, to the geometry, according to the geometry, then what should have actually happened is this will be somewhere at the bottom. It will be like this. Okay.
So why is that, sir?
Okay. I'll do one thing. Just give me 2 minutes time. You are comfortable with differentiation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Guys, I want everybody to concentrate. I know the method that is given in textbook is the horrible method because I'm forced to teach that. Generally, I don't do it. Okay. Now listen, I'll show you an alternate method and then come to that. But as of now, remember till this point, don't forget this, okay? I'm going to show exact mathematical proof for it. Listen. Okay, let us say, this is the point P from where the particle is starting. Okay. What I'm trying to say, I'm saying that this particle P is revolving in oscillation. Wait, I'll show it again. I'm saying that this particle P is revolving like this. Are you able to visualize? Right. So let's say the
yes,
particle
sir.
Is. The particle is revolving in the anti-clockwise direction with an angular velocity omega. Okay, here what is the type of motion we are considering? I told you it is uniform circular motion. Right, did I say it is uniform circular motion? So in uniform circular motion, what is zero?
Zero.
What is zero? The tangential acceleration is zero and angular velocity is constant. Correct? And angular velocity is constant. Right. Now see, so yesterday somebody asked me why should the velocity be perpendicular also, right? That also I'll show you. So if I take this angle as theta, okay, I'm taking this angle as theta, then just like what is the definition of omega? Can I write omega is equal to theta by 2? Because in this case, omega is a constant value. If I write omega is equal to theta by t, then theta will be equal to omega into t. Accept, sir? So theta will be equal to omega into t. So if I take this point as p dash, if this is radius, how much is this? This is also radius. Okay. So if I drop a perpendicular and if I take the center as the origin, I want you guys to tell me the coordinates of point p dash. What are the coordinates of point p dash in terms of coordinate geometry?
So cos theta comma sin theta?
No. If I take the triangle separately, R, this is theta, this is O, this is P dash. If I call this as M, observe now, what is OM divided by R equal to? It is cos theta. So OM is R cos theta or R cos omega t. Similarly, MP is how much? MP dash is how much? R sine omega t. Accepted? So the point P dash is no more cos theta. It is R cos omega t, R sine omega t. Any doubt till this step? Any doubt till this step? I need a confirmation, guys. I just took the basic thing and I... So if I drop a perpendicular, this height will be R sine omega t and this distance will be R cos omega t. Accepted. Now, what is OP dash as a vector? So can I write OP dash is equal to R cos omega t I cap plus R sine omega t j cap? Yes or no? So it is having a value of R cos omega t along x direction and R sine omega t along y direction, right? So I will call this as R vector, which is the radial vector. Guys, I need a confirmation. Is it clear or not? Is every step clear? I'm purely going with mathematics, doing nothing. I'm not applying any physics here. So according to mathematics, R vector is equal to R cos omega t I cap plus R sine omega t j cap. Accepted? Right?
Yes.
So what did I call? This is radial vector. Now you guys tell me, if I differentiate the radial vector with respect to time, what will I get? I will get velocity. The rate at which the radial vector is changing will give you velocity. Correct? So d by dt of R cos omega t I cap plus R sine omega t j cap. So what is this? So what are all the things I can take out of the derivative? So R, I will take it out. Here also R into d by dt of sine omega t j cap. I hope it is clear till this step. Okay. Now, R into, I want you guys to tell me the derivative of this. See, before that, I will give you a hint. D by dx of cos x is how much?
Minus sin x.
Okay. Then what is d by dt of cos 2x? Sorry, d by dx of cos 2x.
Minus sine 2x.
So minus sine 2x is there, no? Actually, I will teach you something slightly out of the context. Minus sine 2x into, you have to differentiate. If the angle is anything other than x, then you need to differentiate that angle also separately into d by dx of 2x. Okay. That is called as chain rule, which you will be learning in depth in your 12th standard. But this knowledge is sufficient to solve this problem. So minus sine 2x into, what is the derivative of 2x?
2.
So the answer is actually minus sine minus 2 sine 2x. Okay, just for my satisfaction, you guys tell me d by dx of sine 5x.
5 cos 5x.
So 5 cos 5x. You understood how you got this 5? So derivative of sine is cos, write the same angle into differentiate that angle, you'll get a 5. Okay, in a similar logic, you're differentiating with respect to time. Here you don't have time, you have a coefficient omega. Okay, so r into, tell me, derivative of cos.
Minus omega or sine omega.
That's it. Minus omega sine omega t I cap plus r into, what is the derivative of this?
So why is t coming again, sir?
It will come, no? Because you are differentiating with respect to time. R into, tell me, derivative of sine omega t. Who wants to try? Guys, if you try only, you are
going omega to cos omega.
Omega cos omega t into j. Okay. So minus r omega t sine omega t I cap plus r omega cos omega t j cap. Now, what is this derivative of r vector with respect to t? Then, this is what I called it as velocity. Correct, Ada? Right? So, if I take this as radial vector equation number 1, if I take this as equation number 2, then to prove r vector and v vector are perpendicular, can I say r vector dot v vector is equal to 0. Am I clear with this? So if two vectors are perpendicular, a vector dot b vector is 0 because it is ab cos theta, and which implies ab cos 90 degrees is equal to 0. Guys, am I clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what is r vector? You guys remember how to do the dot product? 2i
yes,
cap
sir.
Plus, okay, let me just revise it. 2i cap plus 3j cap dot 4i cap minus 2j cap. What is the dot product of this? Multiply the coefficients of I, you will get 8, and multiply the coefficients of j, you will get minus 6. So that will give you 2. Right? In a similar way, what is r vector? Are you guys making a note or just listening? Leave some space and make a note also. There is an alternate way of deriving things. Okay, what is the R vector?
Sir, R cos omega, omega t
I cap plus
R sine omega t.
Very good. R sine omega t j cap dot, what is v vector? Minus r omega sine omega t I cap plus r omega cos omega t j cap. Right? Now do the dot product and tell me. R into minus r omega minus r square omega cos omega t into sine omega t. Just leave it as it is. Plus r into r omega. So r square omega into sine omega t into cos omega t. What is the answer? Because this and this are the same with opposite signs, is equal to 0. So can I conclude that r vector and v vector are perpendicular? Yes, sir. Guys, yes or no? Right?
Sir,
yes.
How did you cancel, sir?
No. I didn't close anything. So after doing dot product, I got zero down. Yesterday, who asked me, why is R and B, how can you say that R and B are perpendicular? I gave the geometrical reason. Who asked me yesterday?
Sir, I guess I asked, sir. You told me that out. Tangent,
yeah, from the I told the tangent reason, right? Yes. Now I'm giving an alternate reason. Now are you convinced that vectors is also saying that R vector and V vector are perpendicular? Right? So this happens only in the case of circular motion, uniform circular motion. Okay. Now, what is V vector?
Sir, I have a doubt here, sir.
Please tell me.
Sir, here instead of writing omega t, we could have kept theta itself, right?
If you keep theta, then things will be slightly difficult. Because I'm going to do second area differentiation. I'm going to do a second order. I'm going to differentiate it again.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now you will understand it better. See. But see, I know it is slightly tough for the current knowledge that you people have, but my trial is to improve it. Okay, I want your thought process to improve. So concentrate and learn this. There's something new that you're going to learn today. So V vector is equal to minus R omega into sine omega t I cap plus R omega into cos omega t j cap. I just copied it from here. I just took the second equation and wrote it. Now, when I differentiated R vector, I got V vector. Now, when I differentiate B vector, what will I get?
Tangential acceleration.
I don't know whether it is tangential or radial. You will get acceleration. What acceleration it is, we will see. I will get an acceleration. I hope that point is clear, right?
Yes, sir.
So, d by dt of minus r omega into sine omega t I cap plus r omega into cos omega t j cap. Now you guys tell me that. Minus r omega into d by dt of sine omega t I cap plus r omega into d by dt of cos omega t j cap. Correct? Why did I take out r and omega outside? Because r is the radius and omega is uniform angular velocity. So they both are constant. So I took out of the derivative. So minus r omega into derivative of sine omega t is, if you guys tell me, I want to see who's going to try.
Minus omega sine omega t.
Why minus? It is only omega, no? Omega cos omega t I cap plus r omega into, tell me for this.
Minus omega sin omega t.
Okay. Minus omega sin omega t j cap, right? So I will push this r inside and take out the omega. So I will have minus omega square into r cos omega t I cap minus omega square into r sin omega t j cap. Convinced? I did nothing. I pushed r inside, I took the omega outside. Okay. So I want you to write it along with me. If you write, you will have a better clarity. So what can I take out common from both? Minus omega into r cos omega t I cap plus r sin omega t j cap is what? This is the acceleration. But if you guys have made a clear note of it, what is the first equation that I wrote?
Well, this what is same as radial vector.
Yes. So it is minus omega square r vector, or I can write it as omega square of minus r vector. Right. So where did you get this acceleration from? This acceleration is occurring due to the change in velocity. It is because of dv by dt that you got. Right? I did instantaneous value. Right? So A vector and R vector are opposite to each other. So what would be the name of this acceleration? So what will be the name of this acceleration?
Centripetal.
Yes. This is what is centripetal acceleration. Okay. So one point I want you to remember is you got the centripetal acceleration. So this is the formula also. Actually, we have derived it. If you want, I'll give you another task also. What you can do, you do the dot product between the third and the second equation and see, you will again get a zero. Meaning, acceleration, this acceleration and velocity are again perpendicular. Okay. So, radial vector is perpendicular to velocity vector. This acceleration which you get from the value of dv by dt is also perpendicular to velocity vector. Hence, this acceleration is always directed towards the center. That is the reason why it is called a centripetal acceleration.
Sir, how did you conclude that acceleration is centripetal?
Because this is the one which is directed towards the center. Huh? So, we should give a name to it, no? Acceleration and r vector are exactly in opposite directions. What are anti-parallel vectors? See, a vector is equal to minus 2 times b vector. How are these two vectors? These type of vectors are called as anti-parallel vectors.
Yes, sir.
So I use the same law. Instead of 2, I have omega square. That's the only difference. Instead of A vector, I have acceleration vector. Instead of B vector, I have R vector. So they both are anti-parallel vectors.
Sir, but is R vector directed outward?
R is in this direction. Because R is always in this direction. So when R is directed in the outward side, acceleration is always directed in the inward side. So inward is towards the center only, no?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Sir,
so velocity vector and A vector will coincide each other?
No, they will not coincide. You want, you do the dot product.
Then how will they be?
No, they will not, because this velocity is not changing. There is a lot of concept in this. I'm repeating it again. This is one of the toughest concepts, okay? That is why, you see, I took 2 days to explain this concept. Never I have taken this much. The Kaulo detail I am explaining. Okay. See, this V vector is changing its direction. I am again repeating one point. I am talking about uniform circular motion. In uniform circular motion, what happens is velocity vector will only change its direction. It is not going to change its magnitude. Means there will be no tangential acceleration taking place. There will only be a radial acceleration taking place. So, what I'm trying to say here is, you might get a doubt. Sir, acceleration itself means change in velocity. Correct? But when I say change in velocity, what is velocity actually? Velocity vector is magnitude of velocity and direction. We know that any vector can be written as magnitude times direction. Am I clear, guys? I need confirmation. So, what I'm trying to say is, in this context of uniform circular motion, B vector is constant in terms of which two parameters from here? There are two parameters. One is magnitude, one is direction. What is constant?
Magnitude is
constant. Magnitude is constant, but direction is changing. Means, I can say velocity vector is changing. Look at my statement. I'm using the word velocity vector is changing. I never use the word speed is changing. Okay, these are all the keywords that they will use to confuse you in assertion and reason. So that is why I listen to my statement carefully. I think you got a question also. I think DIB students' paper, I saw something like this. Will there be a force acting when the object is in circular motion? I don't know why they asked that question, but yes. There will be a centripetal force acceleration acting, centripetal force acting on the particle in circular motion. This is the reason. So, in this context, what is happening is, if velocity vector, the tangential component, is changing in terms of magnitude and direction, listen to this carefully. If V vector is changing in terms of both magnitude and direction, that is called as non-uniform circular motion. Whereas, if V vector is changing only in terms of direction, then it will be uniform circular motion. So, the concept of centripetal acceleration is existing because of the change in direction of velocity. It is not happening because of the change in magnitude of velocity. Okay, please make a clear note of all these points that I told. Write it down.
Okay,
this
sir.
Is, these are all the points on basis of which your assertion, reason, or case studies will be asked. Please write it down. If there is anything you want me to repeat, I'll tell you. If there is any statement you want me to tell, I'll tell you. All these are important points.
Yes, sir. Sir, then what is angular velocity according to this?
Angular velocity is something else. Angular velocity means the rate at which the angle is changing. Okay, I'll give you an example. Let's say there is a vector line like this. Okay. You want to visualize how it looks like, right? See, angular velocity is slightly a complicated study only, but I'll tell you the simpler version of it. Okay. So initially, the blue color line and the red color line are lines are coinciding. Okay. So initially, what is the angle between them? Zero. Let's say the blue color line is fixed and one vector starts revolving. Okay. So that the first vector is sweeping some angle. Sweeping means it is making some angle theta with respect to the original line. Sure, yeah. Let me call this theta as pi radians. I'll call it as pi by 6, 30 radians. Okay. And let's say the time it took to cover this pi by 6 is 3 seconds. Then angular velocity is defined as the amount of angle that the radial vector has swept divided by the time it has taken, which is pi by 18 radians per second. Means they're trying to tell us in 1 second, the rate at which the angle is getting changed is pi by 18. Means in 3 seconds, the total angle covered is pi by 6 radians. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So linear velocity has something to do with linear displacement. Angular velocity has something to do with the angle that is being swept. That is, angle should not be measured in terms of degree. Okay. This is also an important point. The angle, when you're trying to speak in terms of angular velocity, should not be measured in terms of degree. It should be measured only in terms of radian. Make a note of all these points.
Sir, if we calculate the angular velocity as pi by 18 in this case, then can we convert this angular velocity into linear velocity?
Yeah, you can do that, provided you know the radius of this. So if you know the radius of this, then you can write V is equal to R into omega.
Sir, but it will differ, right, for different arc lengths.
Yeah, but but one circle will have only one radius. Why are you worried about different circles? Angular velocity is defined only for one circular motion. Why are we going to take multiple circular motions and compare them? Got it.
And for the same angular velocity, we have different linear velocities, right?
Yeah, you will. You will. You will have it.
So what do you mean by A vector and R vector are opposite to each other?
Opposite means R vector is measured from the center towards the circumference of the circle. Okay. And A vector is measured from the circumference towards the center. So this is A vector, this is R vector.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, so Subhriti, to answer your question, this dv by dt is there, no? The change in velocity with respect to time is what is giving rise to the centripetal acceleration. The same, instead of dv by dt, we are taking delta v by delta v. That is why it is always directed towards the center. Since here we are going with respect to geometry, it is a bit confusing. Just have to go with that statement. Okay. So delta V by delta T is directed towards the center. And this limit delta T tends to 0, delta V by delta T is what we call it as centripetal acceleration. Actually, if you observe the derivation, right, the derivation is only four steps. But there are a lot of concepts that you need to understand. That is the trickiest part. Guys, is there anyone having confusion with the vector proof that I gave? Is it clear?
Oh, sir, could you go to the previous slide showing the geometry?
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So now I hope you're able to relate it, right? Instead of delta V by delta T, here we have, where is it? You have dv by dt. That is the reason. Okay. Now, this delta V is always directed towards the center of the circle. So, delta V by delta T is also directed towards the center of the circle. Now, what we are going to do is, we will say that this triangle and this triangle are similar. Why? That point also I will read it. See, let the angle between the position vector r and r vector be delta theta. If this is taken as delta theta. Since the velocity and v vector are always perpendicular to the position vector, the angle between them is also delta theta. Okay, this I have already proved. Therefore, the triangle, what will happen, CPP dash and GHI, which is formed by the velocity components, are similar triangles. So when they're similar triangles, the corresponding sides will be in the same ratio. So what are the corresponding sides? Delta R and delta V are the corresponding sides. R and V are the corresponding sides. So delta V by V will be equal to delta R by R in terms of magnitude, because you're taking the length of a side, because delta V can be negative also, we don't know. So delta V by V is equal to delta R by R. Then delta V will be equal to V into delta R divided by R. Right? Wait, let me write it again. So since the triangles are similar, delta V by V will be equal to delta R by R in terms of magnitude, which implies delta V is equal to V into delta R divided by R. So dividing with delta T on both the sides. So delta V by delta T is equal to V by R into delta R divided by delta T. Okay. Now what I will do is I will take limit delta T tends to 0 so that I will get the instantaneous value. Delta V by delta T is equal to V by R into limit delta T tends to 0 delta R by delta T. So limit delta T tends to 0 delta V by delta T. Now you guys tell me, whatever we did as dv by dt in the derivative differentiation is the same as limit delta t tends to 0 delta v by delta t. Okay. So what is this called, guys? Rate of change of velocity down. Guys, a simple question is what I asked. What is the rate of change of velocity?
Acceleration.
V by R into what is the rate of change of displacement?
Velocity.
Velocity. So A will be equal to V square divided by R, and this A is what is called as centripetal acceleration. So centripetal acceleration formula is V square divided by R, but we know that V is equal to R omega. Take it and substitute it here. AC will be equal to R square omega square divided by R. R and R will get cancelled. It will be omega square R. So you wrote the vectors part, right? Go and check that result and this result. In terms of magnitude, aren't they the same?
Yes, sir. Magnitude, they are same, but direction.
Direction will be different. Here, I didn't take direction because we already told it theoretically that the acceleration is directed towards the center. Okay. So whenever you already, so when you're dealing with vectors, right, this is a thumb rule. Not only here, throughout your life, wherever you're dealing with vectors and physics, only thing that you need to do is if you have already mentioned the direction, then you need not show it in the expression. Only if you want to take the help of vectors to understand the direction, like how I did in the differentiation case, then you need to write them in the vector.
Could you say how are the triangles similar?
Because the angles are same, no? They are derived from the same triangle, same this thing, no? I already proved this. This is the reason. If angle between the two lines is theta, then the angle between their corresponding sides is also theta only. That is the reason. So they will be similar triangles. Okay. So I just want to conclude by one thing. Okay. I know that you don't have a subjective exam, but it's better you know the proof of it. So the first proof is the steps to be followed are, so you have to, once you draw the circle, consider R vector, R dash vector and delta R vector. Okay, this is step number one. Step number two is consider V vector, V dash vector and delta V vector. Okay. So after you do this, what you need to do, the second step is, let angle between R vector and R dash vector be delta theta. Then angle between V vector and V dash vector will also be delta theta, since they are formed from the same perpendiculars. Third step is, say that they are similar triangles. So once you say that they are similar triangles, take delta V divided by V is equal to delta R divided by R in terms of magnitude. Fifth step is, delta V will be equal to V divided by R into delta V, sorry, delta R. And the sixth step is, divide it with delta T on both the sides, V divided by R into delta R divided by delta T. Seventh step is, take limits on both sides where delta T tends to zero, delta V by delta T is equal to V by R into limit delta T tends to zero, delta R by delta T. Okay. So this one will be acceleration, V divided by R into, this one will be velocity. So A is equal to V square divided by R. Remember this formula. So whenever you are right.
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, from the fifth step to the sixth step, what are we actually doing in that?
Dividing with delta T on both sides. Divide with delta T on both sides.
Sir, but delta T is equal to, it's like, sir, but delta T is tending to zero, right?
That is, see, how can you write delta T is tending to zero without putting delta T in the equation? Correct. See, fifth step, I can't write delta T is tending to zero because fifth step doesn't have any delta T in it. Only if I introduce that, then I can say that it is tending to zero.
Got it, sir.
Okay.
For any triangles to be similar, we should at least have two parameters, right? Here only one angle is same.
The remaining will come down. You can take, no? Delta R and delta V are perpendicular.
Could you say it again?
I'm saying we proved that delta r and delta v are also perpendicular. So they will form a similar triangle.
Oh, okay, got it, sir.
So could you scroll down? Sir, to the steps, sir.
Okay.
Sir, when do we limit delta t to zero?
That is when you want to find an infinitesimally small value. That is when you want to find instantaneous value, if I have to be more specific. So delta v by delta, that is sixth step is an expression for average values. Seventh step is an expression for instantaneous values.
Got it.
Okay. But from my point of view, since this time pattern is different, I want you guys to remember this thing. Right. A is equal to V square by R or R square omega. Okay, this is the thing that you guys need to remember. And with this, this chapter is over. There are a few simple examples that we need to try that we can do it in the next class and we can go to the other part. But I'm very particular that this chapter you guys have to master because it is a combination of vectors, projectile motion, and uniform circular motion. These three have to be studied. So I'll give you time for this whole week, and on next Saturday, not the coming Saturday, on the next Saturday, there will be a test in this, and it is going to be subjective. I'm not going to conduct MCQs. I'll conduct a subjective with assertion reason, case-based studies, and little bit of MCQs also, because it is an I will know where you guys stand and how much you have understood. Okay. So that will be conducted. So start preparing accordingly. Clear? So I'll see you all on the next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.